Hi everyone, once again welcome back to my YouTube channel BeCloudGuru. I am back with another tutorial on one of the very important and critical services offered by AWS, that is AWS Route 53. Today we are going to talk about Amazon Route 53, which is the DNS services offering from AWS. This is the part 1 and we would be discussing very briefly about Route 53 and what it can do for us. In this part, then we'll talk about the DNS basics, because before we start configuring the Route 53 in the next part as our DNS service, it would be helpful to know a bit about the very basics of DNS services, which includes how DNS works, then the resource records which are supported by Route 53, and some of the key differences between CNAM and ALIAS records. I will also discuss about the domain registration and the authorized agencies for the same. So let's get started, guys. So let's see what is Route 53 is all about. First of all, let's discuss how come the name Route 53 came into the picture. The name Route 53 has two parts. If you look at it, there's a route and then 53. The 53 is the number which is a well-known TCP UDP port used by a DNS service. While the word route was picked up from US Route 66, also known as the Will Rogers Highway, the main street of America or the Mother Road. It was one of the original highways in the US highway system, and it became one of the most famous roads in the United States. And this became the origin of word route in Route 53. So that's why we call it Route 53. As I said earlier, this is a DNS service offering from AWS, which is very highly available and scalable. It has three main functions we can use in any order or in any combination. The first one is domain registration. If you need a website name such as bcloudguru.com, Route 53 lets you register a name for your website or for your web application, which is known as a domain name. Route 53 also allows you to migrate your existing domain names from other service providers. DNS routing. When a user opens a web browser and enters any domain name or URL in the address bar, Route 53 helps connect the browser with your website or web application. Health checking. You can also use Route 53 to send automated requests over the internet to a resource, such as a web server, to verify that it is reachable, available, and functional. You also can choose to receive notifications when a resource becomes unavailable and choose to route internet traffic away from unhealthy resources. Now let's see, before we begin our journey to start configuring Route 53, we should know what happens in the background when DNS routes traffic for your domain. This is the end user. When a user opens a web browser, enters URL in the address bar and presses enter. The request for, let's see, if user wants to reach to a website www.example.com, the request is routed to a DNS resolver, which is typically managed by user's internet service provider, that is your ISP. The DNS resolver for the ISP forward the request for www.example.com to a DNS root name server, which provides the name of the top level domain. So top level domain name servers for the requested domain. In our case, it is .com. If you look at closely from example.com, it's a .com is the top level domain. The request for this time, DNS resolver forwards the request for www.example.com to a DNS root name servers, which provides the name server records for the .com domain. In the name server for .com domain, responds to the request with the name of the name server that are associated with the example.com domain. In this case, it is Route 53 name server, as we are using Route 53 for DNS services. The DNS resolver caches or stores the Route 53 name servers The next time someone browses to example.com, the resolver skips steps 3 and 4 because it already has the name servers for example.com. The name servers are typically cached for 2 days, guys. The DNS resolver chooses a Route 53 name server and forwards the request for www.example.com to that name server. The Route 53 name server looks in the example.com hosted zone for the www.example.com record and gets the associated value such as an IP address for a web server. Let's assume it's 192.0.2.44 and returns the IP address to the DNS resolver. The DNS resolver finally has the IP addresses that the user needs. The resolver returns the value to the web browser. DNS resolver also caches the IP address for example.com for an amount of time that you specify so that it can respond more quickly the next time someone browses to example.com. The web browser sends a request for example.com to the IP address that it got from the DNS resolver. This is where your content is located. For example, it might be a web server running on an Amazon EC2 instance or an Amazon S3 bucket that is configured as a website endpoint. The web server or other resources at 192.0.2.44 returns the web page for www.example.com to the web browser and the web browser displays the page. So guys, this was the basic DNS functionality which happens when you try to access any URL. Let's see, move forward and see what kind of a resource record sets are supported by Route 53. The first one is A record. It is also known as host record, and it contains name to address mapping, and the value would be an IP version 4 address. Then the MX record. It is a record for the mail server or the mail exchanger of the domain. Each value for an MX record actually contains two values, priority and domain name. Priority value would be an integer between 0 to 65,535. If you specify multiple mail servers, the value that you specify for the priority indicates which email server you want your email to be routed to first, second, and so on. The server with the lowest value for the priority takes precedence. For example, if you have two email servers and you specify a value of 10 and 20 for the priority, email always goes to the server with a priority of 10 unless it is unavailable. If you specify a value of 10 and 10 for both the servers, email is routed to the both of the servers approximately equally. Next record is the NS record. NS record identifies the name servers for the hosted zone. The name server know how you want to route traffic for your domain and subdomains based on the records that you created in the hosted zone for the domain. PTR record, or a reverse lookup pointer record. It is the host record which associate an IP address with the fully qualified domain name of host, which normally used in reverse mapping. SOA, or start of authority record. This record appears at the beginning of a DNS zone file and indicates the authoritative name server for the current DNS zone. Contact details for the domain administrator, domain serial number, and information on how frequently DNS information for this zone should be refreshed. SRV, or service locator records. It defines service available in the zone, for example, LDAP, HTTP, SIP, etc. It allows for discovery of domain servers providing specific services. Canonical name, or CNAM record, can be used to alias a host name to another host name. When a DNS client requests a record that contains a CNAME which points to another host name, the DNS resolution process is repeated with the new host name. AAA record type. This is a host to IP version 6 address record, and the value for this record is an IP version 6 address in a colon separated hexadecimal format. So these are some of the records which are being supported by Route 53 services. Now let's see, as I said, there are two type of alias records are supported by Route 53. One is CNAM records and another one is alias records. It's very important to know the difference between these. Although the functionality looks like the same, because CNAME looks like an alias record, but there are certain minute differences are there in the background. Your CNAME record cannot be created at the zone apex or for naked domain names, such as if you have a domain name example.com. The example.com is a zone apex, and you cannot create a CNAME record for example.com. But you can create a CNAME record for www.example.com. But for alias record, yes, you can create an alias record at the zone apex as well. A CNAME record redirects queries for a domain name regardless of a record type. What does that mean? Whenever there is a DNS query happens, if it is for a CNAME record will always redirect the query for a domain name regardless of the query specifications for the record. While for alias record, Route 53 responds to a DNS query only when the name and type of the alias record matches the name and type in the query. If the name and type in the query is same as the alias record, then only Route 53 will respond to the DNS query, otherwise it will not respond. A CNAME record can point to any DNS record that is hosted anywhere, while your alias record can only point to a selected AWS resource or to another record in the hosted zone that you are creating the alias record in. A CNAME record appears as a CNAME record in response to DIG or NS lookup queries, while an alias record appears as the record type that you specified when you created the record, such as A or AAA. The alias property is visible in the Route 53 console or AWS CLI command output. Last but not the least, Route 53 charges for CNAME queries, while it does not charge for alias queries to AWS resources. So those were some of the differences, guys, between your CNAME and alias record. And this is a little pointer to your exams if you are planning to prepare for exams for AWS Certified Solutions Architect. Maximum time AWS expects you to choose as an answer alias record instead of a CNAME record. So go through the questions carefully and see whether it fits to CNAME or the alias record type. 8 out of 10 times alias record would be the correct answer. Let's see, we have spoken about DNS basics and the record types. Let's see what happens when you have a domain registration happens. As I said, Route 53 also acts as a domain helps you in a domain registration as well. You can register your domain name or your website names at the Route with the Route 53. So first, we have an Internet Corporation of Assigned Names and Numbers, which is a non-profit corporation for domain name system management. This is the authority who delegates the responsibility of domain registrations to different registrars. Then we have registry operators or domain registry. A domain registry is a company that owns the right to sell domains that have a specific top level domain. For example, we have VeriSign. VeriSign is a registry operator that owns the right to sell domains that have a .com TLD. A domain registry also defines the rules for registering a domain, such as residency requirements for geographic top-level domains. A domain registry also maintains the authoritative database for all of the domain names that have the same TLD or the top-level domains. The registry's database contains information such as contact information and the name servers for each domain. Now we have domain registrars. Domain registrar is a company that is accredited by ICANN, that is Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers, to process domain registrations for specific top-level domains or TLDs. For example, Amazon Registrar Inclusive is a domain registrar for .com, .net, and .org domains. Then we have domain resellers. They are registrars on behalf of registrars but have no contractual relationship with ICNN, that is your web hosting companies. So company that sells domain name for registrars such as Amazon registrar are the domain resellers. Amazon Route 53 is a domain reseller for Amazon registrar and for its registrar associate Gandhi. Gandhi is the associate registrar for Amazon registrar. Then we have registrant, that is the end user or the customer who registers domain names. So guys, this was the all about the basic of DNS domain name systems. In the next part, we will start configuring the Route 53 in AWS management console. So stay tuned for the next video. Now you know the drill. If you like the video, then please subscribe and like and share it with your friends. And for more such videos, you can always